Dissolution testing is vital in pharmaceuticals, assessing how effectively an active ingredient releases from a dosage form. Key apparatus include basket and paddle types, crucial for different formulations. Factors like agitation speed, temperature, and pH impact results. Understanding the importance of sink conditions and proper calibration ensures reliable testing. Master these concepts to navigate the complexities of QC interviews in the pharmaceutical. Here are commonly asked dissolution test interview questions for the quality control QC department in the pharmaceutical industry, along with brief sample answers or explanations. Basic level questions. What is dissolution testing and why is it important? Dissolution testing measures the rate and extent to which the active pharmaceutical ingredient API is released from a dosage form like tablets or capsules into a solution under standardized conditions. It is critical for ensuring drug bioavailability and batch-to-batch consistency. What are the types of dissolution apparatus as per USP? Apparatus 1, basket apparatus 2, paddle, apparatus 3, reciprocating cylinder. Apparatus 4, flow through cell. Apparatus 5, 6, 7, less commonly used specialized types. Which factors affect dissolution testing? Agitation speed, RPM, temperature, pH, and composition of the medium type of apparatus, sampling time points, tablet hardness and formulation. Intermediate questions: why is 900 ml dissolution medium commonly used? It simulates the physiological condition of the GI tract and provides sufficient volume for sampling while maintaining sink conditions. What are sink conditions? Sink condition means the volume of the dissolution medium is at least 3 times the volume required to form a saturated solution of the drug. It ensures proper dissolution and avoids saturation. What is the ideal temperature for dissolution testing? Typically 37.0 plus 0.5 degrees C, mimicking human body temperature. How do you calibrate a dissolution apparatus? Mechanical calibration, alignment, RPM, temperature check, and performance verification test, PVT, using USP prednisone tablets. Advanced questions. What is the difference between apparatus Y and apparatus 2? Apparatus I basket, used for floating or slow dissolving dosage forms. Apparatus 2, paddle, common for immediate release dosage forms that sink in medium. What are the acceptance criteria for dissolution? Specified in monographs or product-specific standards, e.g. a NLT 80% in 30 minutes for IR tablets. Often follows a Q value, Q is quantity dissolved. What is the role of degassing in dissolution media? To remove dissolved gases like oxygen that may interfere with drug release or cause bubbles on tablets. What are the typical sampling time points in dissolution testing? 0, 5, 10, 15, 30, 45, 60 minutes varies depending on dosage form and method. What is S1, S2 and S3 stage in dissolution? 3-stage approach to evaluate dissolution per pharmacopeial standards, USP PH UR. S1, all 6 units, each unit is not less than QL5%. S2, additional 6 units tested, average of 12 units. S1 plus S2 should equal to or greater than Q, and no unit is less than Q15%. S3, additional 12 units, average of 24 units. S2 plus S3 should equal to or greater than Q. Not more than 2 units are less than Q15%, but no unit should less than Q25%. Practical troubleshooting questions. What could be the reason for poor dissolution results? Improper sample preparation, clogged filters, incorrect RPM or temperature, drug formulation issues, instrument malfunction. How is filtered sample handled? Immediately filtered and analyzed or stored under conditions preventing degradation. What is the use of UV or HPLC in dissolution testing? To quantify the amount of drug released using validated methods. Thank you so much for your attention.